That goal just defied the laws of physics. Hello and welcome back to the Underdogs, episode 5. Now, if you haven't seen last episode, be sure to check it out on the link below. It's very important for what you're about to watch this episode. Now, we just got through the group stages. We are now facing Holland. So, if you want to see how our group stage journey went, which was quite a big one to be fair, link in the description to the previous episode. Now, we've got Holland coming up, like I say, in the first knockout round. Now, I'm not sure how their tournament's been so far, so I'm going to have a look at this now. Their squad at the moment is looking like Depay, weird formation. Depay, Iataren, Van de Beek, Wijnaldum, Frenkie de Jong, of course, Koop Meiners, Ake at left back, De Ligt, Van Dijk, Hatterbert, and Silesen in goal. Got a few decent backup players on the bench as well. In terms of their actual group stage, okay, so in their friendlies, they lost to Portugal. So that's their first bit of quality they've played against, they lost to. Now, we also lost versus Portugal in the warm-up games 2-1. They beat North Macedonia 2-1, beat Hungary 2-0, and they drew 0-0 to Italy. So they've not really had the toughest of groups. I mean, Italy's a tough one, but they're not as good as what you'd think on paper on this game. Hungary and North Macedonia are pretty poor, we all know that. So we should be able to get at them. I'm hoping we do. I mean, they've conceded versus North Macedonia. That's the only goal they've conceded. Compared to us, we lost to Poland 2-1, beat Czech Republic 1-0, and we drew to Croatia 1-1. So we have goals in us. We can hopefully get a result here. I think Holland are probably favourites. Yeah, Holland are favourites for this game. They finished second in their group as well. So hopefully we can get a win here and go to the next round. If not, we'll have to see what happens next. Probably a World Cup campaign if we do lose here. But we'll get into the game, guys, and we'll see how we do. Right, so for this game, I'm thinking of sticking with the same team. I'm looking at Jarrod Bowen here, 6.5. But I'm not sure who'll want to replace him. I think I might stick Grealish there. But then Grealish in previous games hasn't done too well, apart from being off the bench. But I might risk him. We need quality for this game. We need to play our best 11. So on paper, Jack Grealish is better than Jarrod Bowen. So I'll play Grealish. I think Maddison, Declan Rice and Phillips is a good midfield. Declan Rice, 88%, but he should be fit enough to play. So is Maddison. So I think we're good enough. We've got no injuries. Everyone's fit enough to play if need be. So I'm looking forward to this game, see how we do. What's their lineup? Is it a strange formation like we saw in the screen before, or have they changed it up? It is the same formation. Bergwijn up front, no Depay. Depay has been dropped to the bench. Iataren and Van de Beek, Wijnaldum, De Jong, Koop Meiners. So that's pretty much the same team. Oh, De Ligt right back actually. De Ligt right back, Van Dijk, De Vrij, and Ake at left back. So Depay's on the bench now. Daily Blind's on the bench as well. So it's a good team, a very good team. Good midfield, good defence. Hopefully we can get at them. Hopefully Calvert-Lewin can bully Van Dijk. We'll have to wait and see. First highlight to Holland. Bergwijn, De Ligt. Come on, someone make a tackle, please. Van de Beek on this game is very, very good. I'll be surprised if he doesn't score an absolute rocket this game. Okay, left back. De Bergwijn off. Oh, scored. I thought it hit the bar and went over. How has Bergwijn won a header in the box there? Who is marking him? This is not a good start. This is far from a good start. Bergwijn, I'm pretty sure, is very, very small. Nathan Ake with the cross. Nobody's marking him. Literally nobody. Does Pope save that? Did that hit? One second. I'm pretty sure that hits the top of the bar and bounces in. Let's have a look. That goal just defied the laws of physics. The ball's hit the top of the bar. There. The ball's hit the top of the bar and somehow gone in. I'm not quite sure how that's happened. Seems to have gone through the crossbar. But yeah, 1-0 down. That is a far from a good start. Sancho. Come on. Beat one. He's beaten two. He shoots. Blocked. Chilwell. Back to Maddison. To Calvert-Lewin. To Grealish. To Trippier. It's a poor pass. I can't believe that went in. Off the top of the bar, and somehow the game codes that to being a goal. I don't know how. But Bergwijn's through again. Felicity causes a bit of problems with his pace up front. But a good save from Pope there. Yeah, Taran into the box. Good clearance. Grealish counter-attack. Come on. Maybe not. Maybe no counter-attack. We'll leave it. It's fine. Still no shot on target for us. Kieran Trippier has stubbed his toe. I mean, if he can't play with a stubbed toe, then surely he's fine. I think he'll be okay. I don't really want to bring on Max Aarons. I know Max Aarons is good, but I don't want to play him too much in his first tournament, in big games as well. Unless we need to, obviously, then we'll play him. But right now, Trippier's 82% condition. I think he's okay to carry on. Can we get a shot on target, though, please? I had no shot on target in 35 minutes. Yeah, Taran in the box. Good clearance from Lascelles is doing well, actually. Lascelles is doing very well. Calvert-Lewin, come on. It's a 3v3 counter-attack, I think. Look at Grealish. Grealish has got to be played in here. No, Sancho does. Oh, my God. That is an awful miss. That is a terrible miss. What is that? That's a terrible half. 54% possession to them. One shot on target for us. If you look at the other games, Switzerland are beating Germany 2-0. Ireland are beating France 1-0. Italy are beating Spain 2-0. Belgium are beating Portugal 1-0. Austria and Romania are drawing. Scotland are beating Poland. And Ukraine are beating Hungary. So as it stands, there's some big upsets. We need to win this game because at the moment, some big teams are out. Let's go to a team talk. Let's get aggressive here. I might change the tactic up. I feel like Calvin Phillips is not working. I'm going to go for a 4-4-2. Sit both of these on the wing. Have Declan Rice defending. Have him on winger support. Have a Sancho winger support as well. Stick on Callum Wilson, advance forward. Get some pace in behind. I think that could work. That could work pretty well. Trippier is okay for now. It's a risk playing 4-4-2 at halftime. But I need to try something out. We're not exactly attacking well, are we? So 4-4-2 could work. Good old English formation. See if we can continue this for the tournament if we get through here. But Grealish, come on, get a goal. Is that a second yellow? It's got to be a second yellow, ref. Come on. Ake looking like he's in problems here, though. He's got a booking already. Committed a couple of fouls since. I think next foul, Declan Rice. Oh, have the tactics work. Declan Rice, what a header. James Maddison with the assist. That's a lovely goal. Lovely crossing. Declan Rice, far post, back where it came from. 1-1. Love that. Just don't throw it away, boys. Here we go. Another corner. Can we get a goal here? Maddison. Another good set piece to Calvert-Lewin. To Grealish. Oh, straight at the keeper again. I had a couple of chances where I've just hit it straight at the keeper. It's really infuriating. Half an hour left. Now Grealish is injured. Oh, my God. He has got a fight injury. So we've got to take him off. I don't want him out for too long. Jared Bowen is on the pitch. He should be able to do a job. He should be good enough. Declan Rice is tired, but he's been our best player. He has scored the goal, but he's been our best player still. Maybe take Sancho off for McNeil at some stage. But for now, I think we'll hope that Sancho can do something. Maddison in the box. 25 minutes left. Oh, that's a poor, poor corner. Poor clearance, though. Calvert-Lewin cleared by De Ligt. We're definitely on the front foot here. Now, that always means, as a West Ham fan, that we will concede at some point soon. But this is England. Hopefully it's different. And by hopefully, I mean it's definitely not. They're going to score here, aren't they? Nathan Ake to Iataren. To Wijnaldum. Good save from Pope. See, both my midfielders are tired. But they are our best two players. So I don't want to sub them off. It's a very, very tough decision. I might just leave them on. Maddison's useful for set pieces. Declan Rice is obviously Declan Rice. So we'll leave them on for a bit. We've only got one sub left, I think. 20 minutes, Iataren with the corner. Good delivery, Van der Beek over the bar. I think we can definitely sneak a goal here. We'll see how we do. We'll make one more sub before extra time if we get to it. We'll have to see. Declan Rice is absolutely knackered here. Do I go Tom Davis? I don't want to go, as much as Mark Noble's great at penalties, which could be a factor, I feel like his pace will get exploited versus that midfield of Holland. So I'm going to bring on Tom Davis here. His penalty taking is 8. So it's not great. But overall, he's probably the better option than Mark Noble. He could always help us get a goal, to be fair. But 10 minutes left. Can we get a late winner? Maddison, do not lose the ball here to Davis. Lascelles plays it to Sancho, to Maddison. Switches it. That's a great ball to Bowen. Can Jared Bowen, the West Ham man, score the winner? Another shot straight at the keeper. Can we please aim for the corners? It's not hard. It's really not hard to aim for the corners, but clearly it is for these guys. Depay, Iataren. Back into the box, looking like he's going to go to Depay. Nope. Coop Miners, good ball. They're playing well. They are playing good football. I can only hope this is a full-time highlight. He's offside, surely. Nick Pope, what a save. He is offside. Oof. This is tense. Going into extra time by the looks of things for our first knockout game of Euros. Our players will be knackered. If we get through, our players here will be so knackered we'll have to rotate, which is not ideal. Unless we get an easier team, but we'll have to see what happens. We're not even through yet. Don't know why I'm talking about that. But yeah, full-time by the looks of things. 1-1 versus Holland. That's a good result, I've got to say. It's a decent game. Please don't concede now. Godfrey, what a tackle. Okay, so highlights. So, match stats, rather. So, 14 shots each. They've had more possession. In terms of the other games, Germany out to Switzerland. Ireland have taken France to extra time. Italy have beaten Spain. Portugal lost to Belgium. Romania beat Austria. Poland beat Scotland in the end. I mean, to be fair, Lewandowski's far too good. And Ukraine beat Hungary. So a couple of teams went out here. Come on, that's a good ball out wide. It's a very good ball out wide. Trippier, poor defending, over the bar. Right. I can see this going to penalties. I really can. Defence playing well, but they're also knackered. And they've got a Memphis Depay that's fully fit against them. Good ball into the box. Good clearance over from Lascelles again. Lascelles is playing so good. Calvert-Lewin hasn't really done... Him and Callum Wilson haven't really been in the game, to be fair. They've not done anything. Is that a pen? No, he just sort of slide tackled in the box for no reason. Trippier to Davis. Got to be out wide. Back to Trippier. Put a good ball into the box. That's awful. Davis, good switch. Out wide to McNeil. Can McNeil play it through to Calvert-Lewin? He does. Dominic Calvert-Lewin. Oh my God. He is unreal. Just before halftime. 2-1 up. Dwight McNeil assists. Calvert-Lewin with the goal. That is an unbelievable finish. I think that's his third of the tournament, or fourth of the tournament at least. Plays it through. Calvert-Lewin. Lovely left footed finish. 2-1 up. With 15 to go. Now, do I waste time here? Not yet. I think we waste time in about 5 minutes. When he gets to 110, we'll waste time here. Bowing out wide to Trippier. I'm hoping they come onto us. We get a third. We'll have to see if that happens or not. Chilwell into the box. Is that a pen? No, it's a free kick offside. I keep on thinking everything's a penalty. I need to stop with this. Every single highlight. Is it a pen? Is it a pen? Let's time waste. Right, we are 10 minutes away. 10 minutes away, potentially. I don't want to get my hopes up yet because Holland can always score here. Corner ball. 5 minutes left. James Maddison. Absolutely knackered. Taking the corner here. Can he even make the box? I'm not sure he can. Maddison, great ball. Oh, obviously not. Obviously, it wasn't a great ball because the game doesn't think so. But 120th minute here. Are we through to the second knockout stage of the Euros? As Nick Pope has the ball here, he loses it. Oh, no. Don't even... Oh, Jesus Christ, he's offside. I was thinking there for a second, that's penalties. That is penalties. But it looks like full-time here. As Nick Pope time wastes beautifully, I've got to say. The inner Burnley's come out here. What a win. That is an unbelievable win. We've beaten Holland. After going 1-0 down in 4 minutes, Declan Rice, 46th minute. Calvert-Lewin, 105th minute winner. You know what? I'm very happy with that result. We are through to the next round here. Passionate. You've done brilliantly to come back and win this. We could go all the way. I'm not going to lie. I mean, we'll probably get a France. But there's some poor teams here. We've got Switzerland. Italy are probably the best with Belgium. But alongside them, we've got Romania, Ukraine, and Poland. Now, I'm going to jinx it again, but as long as we avoid France, Italy, and Belgium, we could win the next game. Let's have a look who we're drawing against. Trippier's looks to be okay. Grealish has a tight thigh. Now, I'm not sure how long they're out for. Grealish is out for 3 days. Trippier's out for longer with a stubbed toe. So it looks like that we've actually got to play Max Aarons next episode. But who are we playing next episode? That's the question. A very good win. Oh, we have got France. Oh, God. Oh, for God's sake. Now, in the friendlies, we got battered versus France. 4-0. So I'm not expecting big things. We have got France in the quarterfinals. Let's have a look what the tournament looks like. 1 second. So if we do beat France and get to the semis, we would play Switzerland or Belgium. Most likely Belgium. But I think France is probably where we will meet our match and probably end up losing it. You never know. I thought that versus Holland last episode. But I think I'll call it here for this one, chat, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed the episode. If you did enjoy the episode, be sure to subscribe and like. Tune in next time. We'll be playing France. Hopefully, we'll get through to semis. Even if we've reached the quarters, which we have done. I'm very happy with that for our first tournament. Considering all of our players are outside the top six, there's not much quality. So reaching the quarters, I'll take that. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll catch you all in the next episode. See you later, guys.